My group at the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in Zurich is working on the development of functional microbes from the screening of activity, the functional characterization, but also the technology development in order to perform the translation into product and into industry as well. So one of our major topics is the cultivation of gut microbes, so strict anaerobes that can be cultivated in bioreactors from single strains to complex ecosystems. Our activity started with the development of models that allow us to essentially in vitro cultivate gut microbiota while keeping their characteristics in terms of functionality, functions, and also in terms of microbial composition. So for this, we develop systems that are based on immobilization of gut microbes and continuous cultures. And we develop such system for different hosts, but also for different health condition of the host. So ranging from very young, so starting at 2 months old, until elderly people with a condition involving, for example, pathogen infection, as well as models that are investigated in order to mimic the condition of inflamed gut by, for example, providing hydrogen peroxide and creating oxidation in the system. So we have developed this technology together with many systems of strict anaerobic cultures, especially relating to the ENGATE technologies, which are obviously very much challenging, but also very much needed in order to cultivate strict anaerobes. And this mustn't be, I would say, ignored. Cultivation of microbes is absolute necessary in order to study the functions of the microbes. So the molecular methods are obviously very informing, but they are certainly not enough in order in particular to isolate microbes and afterwards to investigate their functional characteristics. So this is really our point of focus in the research, so developing technologies from very small scale, simple technologies using ENGATE tube fermentation to bioreactor systems that allow, for example, to cultivate single strain into well-controlled condition and reaching cell densities, which is most important, that are essentially meeting the expectation of the industry. And this is also a high challenge for with the second generation probiotics, for example, butyrate producers, but those can be cultivated. The question is how the conditions are set, how the system are optimized in order to reach the high cell densities and high activity that are needed for the industrial translation of such microbes. So we work also in more complex system, meaning consortia, and surprisingly and unexpectedly, sometimes consortia are easier to handle than single cultures because each bacteria of a well-designed consortium will allow to create a cross-feeding network that do not then require all ingredients of the medium to be essentially present in the medium for the growth of single microbes. So we work with this consortium and especially founded a company specialized in this technology of strict anaerobes, consortia formulation and development for therapeutic targets. So the company is called PharmaBiome. It's a spinoff of the ETH Zurich and the University Hospital in Zurich. And then the last more complicated stage is the cultivation of the complete microbes or microbiota that are present in the gut. And for this, again, we develop a continuous model, and our very special characteristic is that we use a natural phenomena that occur in the nature for the essentially the development and the cultivation of microbes, which is immobilization, formation of biofilm, and we develop a technology that allows to create these biofilms in the reactor and allows then to create the high cell density which are present in the gut and which are indeed very much required if you want to model microbial interaction. You need to work in the condition, especially of the density of the cell, in order to create the proper exchange, the proper cross-feeding system, and also the proper competition within the microbes. So for this, we developed these models, again, with different tools, different target, and we use these models in order to understand certain biotic and abiotic factors that we can very accurately control in those system. And we also develop a new model, which is called Polyfirm S. So it's a model, essentially, that allows to generate a very controlled microbiota that can afterwards be distributed into different reactors operated in parallel and enabling to compare control situation with treatments that are applied in parallel into the different reactors. So this is a very, very powerful system indeed that allows to investigate all kind of factors, but also including obviously the addition of novel microbes, condition of food components, as well as metabolism of drugs, metabolism of different products that come into contact with the host through the food and through the supplement, and also eventually implement in this system some conditions that are found into gastrointestinal disease, and allowing to study the microbiome response to these conditions independent from the host. So that allows to somehow decorticate the system in vitro with microbes only, and then move to a more complex system that allows to integrate the host, typically animal models, and finally to the real human experimentation, which is very limited, obviously, in terms of possibility to alter conditions. Mm-hmm.